tukenga na pati ya kwanza ya thermometers, nituvise vitu basic, vitu vya kawaida, vile ambavyo tunafahamu kwanza. So, we have to know what is the temperature. Temperature is the degree of coldness or hotness. A sound, the Kelvin instrument for measurement being the thermometer. So, thermometer actually is the device that measures this temperature, and temperature being the degree of coldness or hotness. So, always, as usual, the definition of physics class
part ambayo ni haya maneno na quantitative part ambayo for this case tunaweka tu SI unit. So
constructing a thermometer, unataka kutengeneza thermometer unahitaji vitu vitatu basic vya muhimu sana. So
temperature scale, lazima uwe na scale, as you know, kama una thermometer
yako lazima kuwe na scale.
Sehemu ambayo unasomea reading zako, so lazima kuwe na scale, yes. So lazima kuwe na thermometric property, tutaona maana ya thermometric property, na lazima kuwe na fixed point, lazima kuwe na upper fixed point, lower fixed point, na other fixed points ambazo tutaziona depending on the type of the thermometers. So quickly, thermometric property is actually a substance that varies with temperature,
whose variation corresponds to temperature changes for measurements.
Mercury na alcohol. Kwa ukichukua mercury ukaihiti katika temperatures tofauti tofauti, ita either expand au ita contract. So any substance ambayo ina vary na temperature, na ambayo
variations zina correspond to temperature change for measurement, that is what we call thermometric property. So these are the substances that zinakaa kwenye thermometer specific. As
the thermometer, different types of thermometers na different thermometric property. So kwa mfano zile thermometers za kawaida tunazotumia hospitalini,
it's either ndani kuna mercury au
sensitive, kwa sababu variation yake kwamba inarefuka na kushuka kulingana na temperature changes. So that is what we call the thermometric property. So we have this is a common question, properties of thermometric property. So we know that kama definition inavyosema, lazima it remain liquid, tuseme fluid, kwa sababu baadaye tutaona kuna gas, constant volume gas thermometers na constant pressure gas thermometers. So it should remain fluid over wide ranges of temperature changes. Sio ukaweka thermometer kwenye temperature ambayo ma ikaganda, kwa mfano ile mercury ikaganda au the alcohol ikaganda, inakuwa tena it's not a good thermometric property for such kind of temperature. So it should remain liquid, it should remain fluid, tuseme it's solidify over wide ranges of temperature measurements. Also it should vary linearly with temperature, isiwe na variation ambayo iliweke, lazima iwe linearly with temperature. So kama tunaongeza every 2 degrees centigrade, tuseme hii mercury yetu ina expand, ina expand labda 2 centimeters. For every degrees centigrade rise ya temperature, mercury yetu ina expand kwa 2 centimeters. So it should be uniformly linear that way. Sio kwa 2, tukiweka 2 sasa hivi inaongezeka 1 centimeter, tukiweka 2 baadaye inaongezeka 5 centimeters. No, should be linearly varying with temperature. Varying with temperature. So as the definition says, actually it should vary with temperature. That should have been the first property. So it's actually the basic property, as you can see kwenye definition appear. Also it should obey Boyle's law. So I believe you know Boyle's law. So it should also have constant expansivity.
Somehow na this. So kama ina expand
constantly. Sio ukiongeza temperature mara ina expand, ukiongeza temperature somehow ina contract. So it should have constant expansivity. So this varying linearly ni kwa zile thermometers, kwa mfano hii mikiri tunazo kumia hospitali, lakini for dark thermometers kama hizi constant,
we will speak of expansion of these gases. So the expansion actually should be constant. So just like how it should be uniform varying with temperature for those which are linear in nature, na for those which are bulk in nature, unakuta labda ni kabaloon, so it should be having constant expansivity. So hereby we have different types of thermometers. We have liquid in glass thermometer, manake unakuwa una thermometer ambayo ina liquid ndani. Kwa mfano zile thermometer tunazotumia kawaida hospitalini. So it will either have mercury or alcohol. So we call that ni liquid in glass because ni glass kwa nje ndani inakaa liquid. We also have constant volume glass thermometer. So the volume kunakuwa na container ambayo ina gas. So the gas is maintained at constant volume. So what is changing is the pressure of that gas with temperature. So tunakuwa tunaangalia variation ya pressure na temperature. Well, for constant pressure, you have a container, you may contain your gas maintained at constant pressure. So tunaangalia variation ya volume na temperature ya substance tunayoipima. So we also have platinum resistance thermometer, whereby hapa tutakuwa tunaangalia variation ya temperature na resistance. Hii platinum, as we know, this zina vary, resistance na vary na temperature. So we have thermocouple, thermometer and pyrometer. As you can see, pyrometer inapima temperature kwa kuestimate colors. Sawa, kwa kuestimate kwa kunakuwa na standard reference kwamba ikiwa red inamaanisha temperature fulani. If the kwa mfano kwenye incinerators zile zinazotumika kuburn solid waste kwenye hospitali na vitu kama hivyo. So inside there kwenye furnace labda where the temperatures are very high. So what we can do, tunakuwa na karatasi ambayo lina references za rangi ya kwenye hiyo karatasi na temperature kiasi gani. Rangi kwenye hiyo karatasi kwa tuna compare tunachokiona kwenye furnace, tunaangalia kwenye standard reference yetu. Ah, ile rangi ni njano, okay. So tunaangalia huko njano inamaanisha temperature gani, labda 5000 degrees centigrade. Tunaangalia ile temperature ni kijani, huku inamaanisha nini? Tunajua ni 6000 degrees centigrade. So as you can see in these two thermometers, you can see there is somewhat the change, the relation between pressure and volume, the relation between pressure and volume. So it's the reason why tulisema hapa it should obey Boyle's law. Okay, yes, it should obey Boyle's law so that this is not possible, because at the end we will need the gas in the equation. So if either way kama pressure na volume zitakuwa zina
hizo tayari inakuwa sio fit for use.
So pictures can have some few examples that how the thermometers look like. I know the thermometer kawaida mnaifahamu, ila watu tunatumia hospitali ambao tunaweka kwenye kikwapo unapimiwa na vitu kama hivyo. But so many thermometers, because we have digital thermometers which have different sight mechanism. So tuna hii ambayo ni thermocouple, okay. So we have a metal wire A na a metal wire B. So we know that
scientifically kukiwa na nyaya mbili,
so material mbili au metals mbili ambazo zina different properties, kijoin zinatengeneza voltage, sababu zinakuwa na kwenye waya huu na waya huu different characteristics. So at this point tukiweka kitu chenye temperature, sawa, tukiweka kitu chenye temperature fulani, lazima hii temperature itakuwa na variate na hizi volts hapa. So then we can calculate, we shall see a formula where we can translate that volt into how much temperature inasoma. So kama na kitu changu 100 degrees centigrade nikiweka itasoma volts fulani. So I expect ikiwa ni 0 degrees centigrade ile voltage itakuwa different, itasoma kiasi fine. So somehow inafanana na this other arrangement, okay, arrangement. So we have the chromel wire, you can see huko, then we have another wire,
junction, we shall see later the importance of this, and it's a different, slightly different arrangement. So X
by here we will have since this hot junction and cold junction, they help maintaining these points at different potentials. So at the end, if the cold junction is the standard maintain cold junction at temperature flange, then the hot junction then kwena weko kwenye substance ambayo tunataka tusome temperature. Then eventually mechanism ni kama hii, that temperature will vary with voltage and we have our readings. For constant gas you can see ni bulky. Sawa, ni system ambayo ina vitu vingi na vifaa vingi. This arrangement inatumika for constant pressure na constant gas thermometers, constant volume gas thermometers. So you can see ni bubble, I mean ni bulb ambayo na contain air. So either it is maintaining in constant volume. So what we do ni kwamba kwa mfano we have the container ambayo ina maji, tunataka kupima temperature ya maji. So tuseme level ya maji yako hapo. So we sink hii bulb kwenye hayo maji. Then depending na what type of thermometer, kama ni it's at constant volume, tunajua formula ya pressure is equal to PV divided by T is equal to a constant. Okay, so if we maintain the volume, tukisema ndo maana constant volume thermometer, then tunamaanisha temperature ya maji yatasababisha
pressure
kwenye air ndani, as you can see
temperature will be directly related
according to pressure law. You should remember these things in pressure law. Remember pressure and temperature is like proportional. So temperature rise inasababisha pressure rise. So that pressure will go through, sababu ni pressure, so ina raise ina accumulate, then between these two columns zina balance in such a way kwamba pressure ya hapa, the extra pressure,
sababisha na hii temperature.
Under normal conditions lazima this level iwe inafanana na this level. Okay, lazima this level ifanane na this level.
Extra pressure as a result of temperature ya maji inasababisha an extra raise ya this side mpaka inafika equilibrium na atmosphere.
So the heat that we get ina correspond na temperature ya maji. So we get our readings, tukafanya calculation tukapata.
Same way kama we have this constant pressure, kama tuna constant pressure, so you know Charles law, volume and temperature directly proportional, right? Yes, according to the Charles law, if we maintain pressure constant, volume and temperature is acquired directly proportional. So temperature gain, okay, temperature gain in cause a raise in volume, okay, since they are directly proportional, so that volume accumulates and the extra volume in establish a raise in mercury heat hapa H. So this will correspond to the temperature of our calculation to kapata hiyo temperature. So here they are saying kwamba capillary tubing minimizes quantity of air not at the temperature being measured. Yes, because we have air, we don't expect you to kiweka humu ndani how the air will be heated. Lazima kuna a certain quantity of air ambayo inabaki unaffected. So we put this narrow so that we can restrict only the air ambayo ilikuwa inakuwa affected na the temperature, kuingiza kwenye hii kitu chenye hichi temperature specific, ndio inakuja kucause effect that we get an accurate measurement. So as I said hapa kwenye thermocouple, okay, kwenye thermocouple thermometer, so we have the cold junction na hot junction, okay. So this inatusababishia tunakuwa na vitu viwili, tunakuwa na kitu tunaita reference temperature na what we call invention temperature. So you can see reference temperature is the temperature
that I told you earlier, any temperature
maintain. So tunachokuwa tunapimia ni kule kwenye hot junction. So the reference temperature, inakuwa temperature of the cold junction of the thermocouple, ni reference, so it should be maintained, okay, kule kwenye cold junction. While the kwenye hot junction you can either have invention temperature or neutral temperature. So invention temperature is the temperature at which EMF is zero, and the neutral temperature is the temperature at which EMF is maximum. These are things you should claim. Na tukichora graph, unakumbuka I said what varies hapa ni temperature kwenye hot junction, ambayo tunaweka substance yetu tunayoipima, versus the voltage ambayo inakuwa inasoma kwenye voltmeter. So if we plot a graph of potential difference with temperature, as because that is our thermometric property is this voltage. Okay, this voltage. So how does it vary with temperature? You can see from an experiment you get a parabola. Not really a parabola, but you get an arc kama hii, that graph ambayo inakuwa that way, of course a parabola. So we know at maximum point the temperature at which EMF is maximum, that point the temperature, this point here at which EMF is maximum, is what we call the neutral temperature. And the temperature at which EMF is zero, which is this point here, because you can see EMF for voltage is zero, that's what we call the inversion temperature. It varies from thermometer to thermometer. So a summary of important variation of temperature. Kuna formula ambayo inatumika ku calculate these temperatures.
So ideally, as I said earlier, kwamba friction resistant thermometer na thermocouple zinafanana mechanism yake. So here we have temperature ambayo inasababisha a change in voltage. Lakini actual mechanism, the temperature ina cause difference in arrangement ya electrons, na you remember kwenye current, and inaongeza resistance, potentials na change, and all those variations inasababisha a certain voltage. But for resistance thermometer is the same. Easy measurement the voltage, measurement the current is nakuwa indirect. So indirect implication inakuwa ni indirect implication call, but they actually mean the effect of temperature on resistance. So inakuwa ni ukiweka temperature fine resistance ya emeto ina change, inasababisha different volume because we have voltage. So because we can't measure, hamna kifaa kinachopima resistance kama resistance. Usually ni indirect measurement, tunapima voltage, tunapima current, na resistance inakuja kuwa indirect. So if you can see the equation ya parabola, we know that ni y is equal to ax plus bx squared plus c. So kwa hii graph ya e versus temperature, so we know that y itakuwa ni the voltage au EMF, either way ukiamua kuita, na a is the certain constant, x is the horizontal ambayo ni temperature, plus you can see b certain constant, another one times temperature squared plus a constant c. For this case kwa thermocouple tunashasema reference temperature ni kwenye cold junction ambayo tuna maintain a constant temperature cold for 0 degrees centigrade, and so we can basically ignore this constant. So tukabaki na e is equal to alpha theta plus beta theta squared. So for thermocouple inakuwa guided na this equation. But for resistance thermometer, then kwenye y tunakuwa na resistance. So in this place ya y tunakuwa na resistance. So for resistance thermometer, if you can recall my series of lectures temperature coefficient of resistance, utakumbuka kuna kitu kama hiki. Angalia tu video zangu za temperature coefficient of resistance, na kama unakumbuka vizuri, kama ulikuwa unafuatilia, utakumbuka hii formula alpha theta plus 1. So ukiangalia vizuri inafanania na hii hapa. However, we shall not go to mathematical details sana sana, kwa sababu they are a little bit out of scope. So we shall just know that the general formula, it is more or less the same as vile ya temperature coefficient of resistance jinsi ilivyokuwa derived. So we have so many roots ambazo zinaendelea. So we have alpha theta, so we can put another constant, beta theta squared, and etc 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 etc. Regarding na graph yetu ina curve mara ngapi, you know polynomial, sitaingia kwenye mathematical details. So basically formula yetu ya resistance thermometer huwa inakuwa guided na this general formula. This is what you should know. Okay, remember it is slightly different na ile ya thermocouple. So be careful, as you can see huku R not iko outside na cut across zote. So in brackets R not nakuwa nje, tofauti na EMF. So It is a common concept up, a very good concept, that not it is not always sensible to regard thermometric thermoelectric EMF as a thermometric property. Why is that? It is because thermometric EMF hatuna huaga hatuna variation ya EMF na temperature. Usually hiyo ni indirect. Temperature in affect resistance, which in turn in affect thermoelectric EMF. Okay? So usually it is not very sensible to regard thermoelectric EMF as thermometric property. The actual thermometric property, as we define thermometric property. Kumbuka definition yetu ya thermometric property. Tulisema lazima iwe ina vary na temperature and whose variation na correspond na temperature changes for measurement. Okay? So in real sense, natural correspond na temperature change resistance and not the EMF. So wakikuuliza why I will explain this, that's how you should tell them and be confident that get your marks.
So here we have a comparison, yeah, types of the thermometer. In summary, you can get this table on the understanding physics book. So you can see here we have mercury in glass thermometer, we have constant volume thermometer and constant pressure. Usually they share the same properties almost. Resistance thermometer, thermocouple and pyrometer. So we are comparing the advantages and disadvantages. It's a common question they like to ask. Mention three disadvantages of pyrometer over thermocouple. Mention three advantages or disadvantages. Yeah, one thermometer over the other. So you can just use this table to answer that question. So you can see mercury in glass thermometer. Kwanza inatumia length of mercury thread. Kwa this line ya kwanza inaelezea process ya how the thermometer works. You can see constant volume inatumia pressure of a fixed mass of gas. So if it's constant pressure, inatumia volume of a fixed mass of gas. So you make volume constant, what inakuwa na vary ni pressure. You make pressure constant, what varies the volume. Remember I said that. Resistance thermometer inatumia electrical resistance of platinum coil kama the factor ambayo ina match na resistance. Thermocouple inatumia EMF across the junctions of two dissimilar metals as you saw earlier. Pyrometer ina compare color ya thermometer thermal radiation from a hot object. So inakuwa na scale ikionyesha this color, temperature ni kiasi fulani. So advantages mercury in glass thermometer. So you can see this line up and up what any advantages specific thermometers. So mercury in glass is convenient and portable. Okay, constant volume in a wide range, it's accurate and gives a ideal gas temperature directly. So it measures the mfano kama ni ideal gas temperature yake inakuwa measured directly. Tofauti na other thermometers. So directly it means you can see in the diagram ya thermometer. You can see. So tofauti ya hizi unakuta the varying object is the temperature inasababisha resistance ambayo conversion kuja kuinterpret tena kwenye in terms of thermometer inakuja kuleta errors na all those things. Lakini for this case ina measure it directly. So for resistance thermometer in a wide range, accurate, best type for small temperature difference. First response for thermocouple, wide range readings can be stored in a computer, microcomputer, pyrometer, no contact with hot object, it can be portable. And you can see this line in a consist of disadvantages. The next, so fragile, limited range, for constant volume it's bulky, you can see na mambo vitu vingi ambavyo inahitaji kubeba, and inconvenient, slow to respond, for resistance is slow to respond, for this for accuracy, a high resistance microvoltmeter or potentiometer must be connected, and this one is not highly accurate, because it's just a comparison ya much ya mtu na mtu, subjective. Na range ambayo inaweza kutumika, this is the last line. so from 234 Kelvin to 723 and the rest. So you can just pass through this table. It's a common question they like asking.